Hey friends, it's Corey from Hey Let's Make Stuff, and I'm back with another laser tutorial. So I know that a lot of people have been getting these sort of diode craft lasers, and if that's you or if you're thinking about getting one, you may need some more beginner videos. So this video is for you. This video is specifically about the cut, score, and engrave features of a laser cutter. When I got my first laser, I really wish there had been more beginner tutorials. There were a lot of more advanced tutorials, there were a lot of forums, but there weren't a lot of good beginner tutorials. So my hope is with this tutorial that I can sort of demystify the cut, score, and engrave line types within your laser so that you can make projects faster and easier. So what is a line type? When you bring a file into your laser software, there are three things your laser can do with it. It can cut, it can score, and it can engrave. And you will need to set those settings yourself. Especially if you're using a Glowforge or an X-Tool, those settings can't really be imported from something like Adobe Illustrator or Inkscape. You're going to have to tell your laser what to do with each of the lines in your project. So I have this little example of cutting, scoring, and engraving. And let's talk about each of these in more detail. Cutting is obviously cutting all the way through your material. Your laser is at its most powerful when it is cutting, and it will create the most amount of smoke and debris when it's cutting. Depending on your type of laser, your laser may need to do more than one pass to cut all the way through your material. If you have a diode laser, like a Glowforge Aura or a X-Tool M1, you may find that it needs to do several passes. If you have something more powerful, like a Glowforge Plus or Pro, or an X-Tool P2 or some other CO2 type laser, you may find that it does it in one pass. That's one of those things that makes a CO2 laser so much faster than a diode laser like this Glowforge Aura. When uploading a file to cut, I highly recommend uploading an SVG file or some other vector type file. This is because those files are created in lines and points versus pixels. So I talk about this occasionally in my videos. Photos, JPEGs, PNGs, those are pixels, they're raster, they're bitmap, they've got a couple different names that you may hear them go by. But you really want to use a vector, which uses points and lines to make an image. And if you think about how a laser works, it sort of cuts lines and turns at points. A vector file is just basically the sort of native file that works best in a laser. The two most popular software programs for creating vector files are Adobe Illustrator and Inkscape. I've been working on an Adobe Illustrator tutorial series here on YouTube, so I will go ahead and link to the first video in that series in case you want to get more information on designing your own files. You can make some really fun projects with just cutting. So this is two layers of premium draft board, which I actually cut in my Glowforge Pro. You can cut other wood in here and make the same type of project, but this is draft board. And basically, there's a whole backing piece here. You can see it here. There's a whole backing piece. And then in the front, I cut out all of these individual pieces, and then I painted the frame of those pieces black, and then I painted all the colored pieces inside, and then I set them back in there with adhesive. So this is all cut, there's no engraving, there's no scoring, but you really can make a lot of very cool projects with just cutting. And if you're a beginner on a laser, I would suggest starting with cut. Often it is faster than engraving and doesn't require playing around with the settings quite as much. So if you're just starting out, find yourself some really simple cut projects and start there. You can obviously also combine cutting with scoring or engraving, as you'll see here in a second. Next up, we have scoring. And scoring is basically like a cut, except it's not cutting all the way through. It's using a much less powerful version of the laser. You're basically cutting a very fine layer of material off to leave that score mark. And it's only gonna make an outline. You can't really fill with scoring. That's actually engraving, which I'll get to in a moment. Like with cutting, a score line should also be an SVG or other vector file, just because that is natively how the laser wants to score it. There are a couple reasons you might want to score. Here are just a few of them, there might be more. So I made these cute little coloring ornaments. So you can see that I've cut around the edge of my little snowman here, and then I have a design scored into the wood. And then I had my boys come in with pens and just color these in. They made really, really cute ornaments. I'll link to that tutorial below. But this is just one example of how you might use a score. Another example is if you are making something like a name sign and you have all of your individual letters cut out, you know, you have your big circle, for example, and you have the name cut out, but you have all these individual letters and you don't quite know where to put those letters in relation to the sign. If you score that name on the sign, then you will basically have a map of where to put those letters. So if you're making a name sign, basically all you'll have to do is duplicate that name, put it on top of the circle or whatever other shape you are cutting, set that to score, and then you know exactly where to put your letters for your name sign. And then we have engraving. This basically removes that top layer of material, but more like a field or a fill. The score line is around the edge, but engraving, you can actually fill with it. Engraving is obviously darker than scoring, and you can create a lot of really cool effects with your laser using engraving. You really may want to do some testing with your engraving before you engrave your entire final project. You really want to play with those speed and power settings. So the faster your speed, the lighter your engraving. The slower your speed, the darker your engraving. The more power you have, the darker your engraving, and the less power you have, the lighter your engraving. So you can play with those settings in your laser software to get an engrave that really works with your material. Engraving is generally the slowest process of your laser, especially if you have a craft laser. It can take a long time. So I made these very cute little coasters here when I was playing around with my Glowforge Aura when I first got it. The flowers here are all engraved, and then obviously it's cut around the edge. Each took me an hour to make. So this was a 4-hour project to make 4 coasters, but it has this very detailed engraving that's really pretty. And I was willing to sit here with my laser while it worked to get this effect. Depending on your file or if you're in a crunch for time, you may want to change some engraving settings to score lines. It's just so much faster. It's not nearly as deep or dark, but it is faster. So for example, I wanted to make 150 keychains out of acrylic. I could have engraved all of these hotel markings, and my guess is that you won't be able to see them on camera very well, but I ended up scoring them. And that's because even on my big Glowforge, I was cutting these out of these large pieces of acrylic. It was over an hour per sheet to engrave them, and it was just minutes to score them. So would I have preferred the engraving? Yes. Did I save myself hours and hours of time? Also yes. So it really depends on the project that you're making, where you may want to just try that scoring instead of engraving. Let's also talk about how the laser moves when it comes to scoring and engraving. When you're scoring, it actually follows the outline of the letters or whatever else you're scoring as an outline. When you're engraving, the laser just goes back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. Because you're going back and forth, back and forth, back and forth, that's what makes the engraving process so much slower than the scoring process. For engraving, you can use a wider variety of file types. So yes, you can upload a SVG or other vector file and it will fill it and engrave it. Or you can upload a JPEG or a PNG, you can upload like a photograph, and your laser software will turn that into a beautiful engraving. But note that if you do upload a PNG or JPEG file, something like that, most often your software will not be able to turn that into a cut or a score. It's just gonna be engrave. And then one final fun thing about engraving is I really like to do some of my fills on engraving, especially on acrylic, using a paint pen. So for this little smiley face, you wouldn't normally be able to see that very well because it would be pink on pink. So before I removed the masking, which is what protects the acrylic while it's engraving, I actually went in with my little white paint pen, colored in his eyes and smile, and then when I peeled off that masking, I was able to get this really cute effect. You can use a paint pen on wood as well, but sometimes paint pens tend to bleed into the grain of the wood, so just do some testing to see the effect that you're going to get with your particular material. Finally, let's pop over to the Glowforge app so I can show you how to change these settings within the software. If you are using a different type of laser with a different software, you should have similar features and be able to change these line types just as easily. Here in the Glowforge software, it's actually generally very easy to change your line type settings, though I will say that sometimes files are made in a way that makes it much harder. If your file comes in all in one layer, you can't change the individual parts of that layer to different line types. You can in the Xtool software, which is wonderful, and I really wish the Glowforge software would allow you to do that. So you may need to take this file into a different software like Adobe Illustrator or Inkscape, separate the layers and bring it back in if you're not able to change the line types individually. But for this file, I've set it up so that everything is on its own layer, which will make it very easy to set up our file here. To start, this is an unknown material. This is actually maple, so I'm gonna find that maple. It's like a medium maple hardwood. Now I can go ahead and change my line type. You can see here that it automatically changed some of these. It changed engrave to engrave, but all you have to do is click on the image that you want to change, and here are your line types up here. You can engrave, cut, score, or ignore. If you ignore it, nothing will happen. I use this quite a bit when I'm cutting multiple part projects on a bunch of different materials. I just ignore the pieces I don't want to cut out of that material. Works really well. But for this, we're going to set it to engrave. This is a cut, so I'm going to set that to cut. The word cut is also cut, and the word score is score. So now you can see when I go back here, everything is a bit of a different color. The cut lines are orange, the score line is outlined in purple, and Engrave is filled with purple. And like I said, this should be similar in whatever laser software you're using, just being able to change things to cut, score, or engrave. And that's it. Those are the line types for your laser. If you found this video helpful on your laser journey, I would really appreciate it if you would give it a like. If you want more laser, Cricut, and sublimation content, subscribe to my channel. I'll see you next week.